What's up, everyone? Thank you for tuning back into At Home Dude. I appreciate you. Last week, we went over kids going back to school with COVID being around and everything and how that would affect everyone from different perspectives. We kind of ran long on that video, so I did cut some things out of that video. At the end, I really wanted to be positive and leave you off on a positive note. So I started speaking about if the schools happen to close back down or if children are not able to go to school, just to be positive and some of the things that you can do with your children to educate them in different areas and teach them things that you may have overlooked. So stick around, we'll be right back with some things that you can do mainly for teenagers, but some young kids can also do too. I'll be back right after this. All right, so we're talking about encouraging your kids towards entrepreneurship or towards a business mind, things they can learn, things they can do if they happen to be out of school again. So the first thing we're gonna go over is just taking photos. This is something you could do with a kid pretty much most ages. If they're really young, you can help them do this. So you're gonna take your phone or your camera that you have and you're just gonna go take nature shots, or you can take shots of each other, but you're gonna take the photos and you're gonna upload them to an image stock. There are various image stocks that you can use on the web and you're just gonna upload it. And then when people see them, they might want them or like them. These can be photos of anything. Most of the time, these are gonna be people using them for marketing purposes, but also magazines or content creators can also use photos just to show whatever they're talking about or as an illustration. This is a really cool idea, and like I said, you can do this with kids of all ages. Our next one I included because this is my love, and it's just making music. You can teach your child to play an instrument, or you can teach your child something that they can make music on, for example, a drum machine or whatever the case. Making music for profit is a lot more accessible now than what it used to be. You can buy a program for maybe $100 and it will give them most of the tools that they need to be able to make some kind of music. Obviously, you might need external pieces like a microphone, but this is something you can build into and invest into your child. So 5 years down the line, maybe they will really come into their own and start to make music on a semi-professional level. You can also put your music on websites and it allows people to search the music, listen to it. It can be music or individual sounds, and content creators can use it for whatever projects they are working on. This is also another way to get passive income from your music just sitting on a website, similar to how your pictures would be sitting on a website, and it would be up to other people to browse and find them. Moving on, another thing you can do is to teach your children to code. Coding is pretty much the now, but also the future. Everything is being operated by technological devices, and coding is the script written that is telling the device what to do. Whether it's a future in cybersecurity or coding in general, creating software or even video games, coding is huge in our community right now, and going forward, it will continue to be because everything is essentially devices and technology, and it needs something to either secure it or tell it what to do. This one won't return financial benefits immediately, but going forward, if your daughter is 13 years old and you teach her to code, and maybe you can learn it with her and you go over it every night and she becomes really good at it, then 5 years down the road when she's turning 18 or so, she may be able to get a scholarship doing the coding. So it's definitely an investment more so for the long term. Making a children's book is another really cool exercise you can do. Now, depending on how old your children are, they can also get involved with the marketing side of this, but let's talk about making the book first. Now, what I am referring to is on Amazon, you can create digital books and people can download and look at them. The part you would do with your children is to make up the story. So they can be any age for this, and you would come up with a story together. And then you can contract out someone to do the cartoon drawings or illustrations for you. Now, you could also do the illustration yourself if you're up to that task. But anytime a child comes up with a story and tells you, hey, I have this story, it's on Amazon, it's pretty much adorable, and that's something they can get into and try to start to learn entrepreneurship and marketing and start pitching their book to family members and friends and try to get some sales on their book once it's on the Amazon bookstore. Now, this list can go on and on. I didn't mean for this episode to be super long, but some of the other things that you can help teach them that you may be overlooking, and honestly, I went to college and kids didn't even know this there, but proper cleaning. Show them how you clean things, because sometimes kids grow up and it's never actually explained. Maybe their parents just assumed that the kid would kind of figure it out, but if you found a great way to clean something, definitely let your kids see you do it and explain it to them. That is something that can be a bonding exercise, and it has something to do with learning. Also, washing clothes. I can't tell you how many of my friends in college didn't know, even though the instructions are usually on the lid of the washer. They didn't know how to wash their clothes, so that was very surprising. That's something else you can do. Cooking is another thing. It's fun, you get to eat, and it's basically science. So you can pretty much break it down to whatever age level they're at and they can understand cooking, how to cook, make your favorite recipes, and it's a good bonding experience also. Another one is taxes. Even though it may not be tax season, you can learn about taxes yourself, and also your children can learn about how important it is to pay their taxes. So obviously this is an entrepreneurship type of video. Being an entrepreneur or a self-made business person, you really have to know about what you need to put away for taxes and how exactly to go about doing that. Taxes can be pretty simple, and it's something that has gotten plenty of popular people in trouble. So definitely give your kids that leg up. Along with taxes would be plenty of other financial things like balancing a checkbook also. But the last thing I'm gonna go over is just growing your own food. I believe gardening and growing food is very important for people to know. My green thumb is not very good, but I definitely need to work on it myself too. So these are the main things that I wanted to bring to you. I wanted to bring you some positivity this week. And if our kids don't end up back in school, these are some of the things you can teach them to help them learn. They are unconventional and not what they would learn in school, but I consider a lot of these things to be critical for them to know in the world and know going forward. I hope you guys really enjoyed this short episode today. I hope you are doing well out there, and hit the like button if you like this and want to see more content like this. Throw me something in the comments that you think your kids should learn, and I will see you next time. Thank you. Bada bing, bada boom. Hey, yeah, yeah.